weeds growing up. The paint is peeling on your shutters, and that backyard fence is absolutely atrocious. You couldn't slap some varnish on there or something? I mean, your house is an eyesore.
We know you want to come over and do the work there?
No, that's not our job. You know when you moved in that you were supposed to take care of things like this. It's part of your contract with the neighborhood association.
Whatever. What do you want right now? I'm like half asleep. What do you want?
Well, I want you to know that we have had to take action since you have ignored our correspondence, and we're sorry we had to do this.
You had to do what?
We have had to impound that ugly car of yours. What is that, a Dodge? That's
what?
That's absolutely atrocious looking.
Are you kidding me?
No, we've had
to impound my car.
Yes, we impounded your car.
Hold on. You motherfuckers impounded my car?
Yes, it's what we had to do. I mean, we had to get notice somehow. You've ignored every correspondent.
Are you kidding me? You guys impounded my fucking car?
Yes, sir. Sorry.
Sorry.
You should have taken care of all this stuff I just previously mentioned, don't you?
No, you didn't say you were going to impound my car. That was not on the contract.
Well, you should have read the fine print.
How did you impound my car?
We came out early this morning and just impounded it because the lawn hasn't been mowed, the shutters are just awful, backyard fence is atrocious, and that car is just disgustingly ugly. I mean, you should be glad that it's not out in front of your house.
You came in the morning without telling me and impounded my f***ing car.
Don't worry, we didn't scratch it or anything.
I don't care, it's gone. I need that to get to work.
Then maybe you will go out and take care of these things that are listed right here.
You know what? You didn't tell me this was going to happen. This is against the law. You didn't tell me you're going to impound my car.
Look, we're the Neighborhood Association. We can do anything we want.
No, you can't do the Neighborhood Association. You're a bunch of, like, stuck-up pricks anyway. Like,
no, there's no need for name-calling.
Whatever, you've been just trashing my car in my house, so whatever, you.
Excuse me?
You heard what I said, you.
Well, instead of sleeping all day, maybe you should get out and mow that lawn.
Maybe you should mind your own business.
No, I'm with the Neighborhood Association. You shouldn't be sleeping. You should be out mowing your lawn and fixing that fence and fixing the shutters and get you a new car. You should be glad to get rid of that car.
Are you kidding me right now? Listen to yourself.
Do I sound like I'm kidding you?
You do. You're in the Neighborhood Association acting like you're God right now, telling you what I should do with my house and my car. You.
Well,
you better go and get my car right now before I call my lawyer.
Let me ask you something. Do you kiss your wife with that mouth?
You know what? That's none of your business.
Well, we've got your car, so nah, 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 nah.
Maybe we can get together face-to-face and talk about this if you want to talk to me like that.
Oh. What, you're going to try and harm me physically?
Did I say that? I said maybe you should come down to my ugly house and we'll talk about that.
Well, maybe I'll drive down there in your car.
Come down here and do that.
Okay, well, I'm
down here
to,
and do that.
Listen, potty mouth. Can you kiss your wife with that potty mouth?
You know what? We need to get my car out of the impound,
well,
right?
Well, here's the deal. The reason I ask is your wife told us to call you and tell you,
Are you serious?
So where's my car? Barbara parked it around the corner.
Yeah. Are you kidding me?
That's what you get for being born on April Fool's Day.
Man, I feel like such a dumbass right now.
Well, you should be. Happy birthday and April Fool's.
Hey, thank you.
All right.
It's a good way to start the day.
Yeah.